गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम शहज़ा मोता एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द पोएम द लास्ट बार्गेन. द लास्ट बार्गेन पोएम इज रिटन बाय रबींद्रनाथ टैगोर एंड इज बेस्ड ऑन द मेन थीम ऑफ इज दैट समटाइम इट इज बेटर टू बी फ्री ऑफ द कन्फाइनमेंट ऑफ ऑब्लिगेशंस प्लेस्ड बाय मनी और पावर. This poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. Before starting the poem, let's study about Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was born on 7th May 1861 in Calcutta. He was also known as Bhanu Singha Thakur, Gurudev, Kavi Guru or Biswakpi. He was a Bengali poet, writer, music composer and a painter too. He got many awards for his work. His works are like Gitanjali Gaura, Rabindra Sangeet, Jangan Man, Amar Shonar Bangla and many other. In those, Jangan Mana we all know is India's national anthem. Amar Shonar Bangla is a Bangladesh national anthem. He died on 7th August 1941. Now, if we talk about this poem, this poem's speaker is Rabindranath Tagore. The poem is about someone looking for a job. As in society, nobody likes to be called as a jobless person. So he wants to get hired, but without losing his freedom. The poet tells us that he received many offers from the rich, the powerful and the beautiful. However, he turned them all down. At last, he met an innocent child and he immediately accepted his offer. Now, as we start the poem, "Come and hire me," I cried, while in the morning I was walking on the stone-paved road, sword in hand. The king came in his chariot. He held my hand and said, "I will hire you with my power." But his power counted for naught, and he went away in his chariot. Now the first offer came from a king. Early in the morning, he had more power than wealth. He offered the man his power in return for the man's labor. The man, however, felt that the king's might was not worth much, so he refused the king's offer. Means, he didn't want to lose his freedom. Dear students, there are the meanings also on the underlined words, so please refer to them also. Next paragraph is about the afternoon time. In the heat of the midday, the houses stood with shut doors. I went out along the crooked lane. An old man came out with his bag of gold. He pondered and said, "I will hire you with my money." He weighed his coins one by one, but I turned away. Now there's a rich man's proposal. The second offer came in the midday when it was really very hot. An old man offered him a lot of gold in return of his labor. The man was not much impressed. The wealth didn't attract him, so he refused that offer. Because in this case also, if the man is paying gold coins, so he would be needing his labor also. So in that case, his freedom will be gone. Here are some meanings for the crooked lane. Crooked is bent or twisted lane. Wandered, roamed aimlessly. Pondered, thought carefully before deciding. Turned away, again rejected and went away. Now the next offer. It was the evening. The garden hedge was all aflower. The fair maid came out and said, "I will hire you," with a smile. Her smile paled and melted into tears. And she went back alone into the dark. Now the next proposal was from the beauty. Fair maid is called for the beautiful unmarried girl. Now it was the evening time. There was a natural beauty all over, as the whole garden was blooming with the flowers. There was flowers in the hedge. A beautiful girl came to the man. She gave a pretty smile. She offered to give the man her smiles in return for his labor. However, the man found that her happiness was only sorrow in disguise. Means her happiness, her smile, will not be valid as if whenever he felt sad. So he refused that offer also. Now the last proposal. The sun glistened on the sand and the sea waves broke favoredly. A child sat playing with shells. He raised his head and seemed to know me and said, "I hire you with nothing." From henceforward, that bargain stuck in child's play made me a free man. So now the last proposal. Ultimately, the man came to the seashore. There he found a child playing with shells. The child offered to take his services in return for nothing. The man accepted the offer because while playing with the child, he was still a free man. He won't be bounded. So dear students, hope this story is clear to everyone, because as the story is reflecting the importance of freedom. Thank you very much.